We begin with breaking news this morning, and a man is clinging to life after he was stabbed multiple times in a convenience store on the New South Wales Central Coast. Police say two men entered the shop on Warner Avenue in Wyong at around 9:30 this morning when a fight broke out and the victim was stabbed. The offenders made a run for it and still have not been caught. The victim, believed to be in his 40s, is in a critical condition. And two gunmen have fired a volley of bullets inside a five-dock apartment, killing a man and seriously injuring another. Live now to Ruth Wynne Williams. Ruth, have police found the shooters?
Mark, large parts of that inner west suburb are still cordoned off this morning as police hunt for those two men who they say burst into an apartment around 3:45 this morning, shooting the men who were inside. One of those men has died. He couldn't survive the gunshot he took to his head. Another man is here at Royal Prince Alfred Hospital today. He's being treated for a wound to his arm. Police say they don't know how these two men made their way into that apartment this morning, but the gunshots were certainly so loud they woke neighbours.
Did you hear?
I hear just bang, bang, all noise. That's it.
And it was quite loud. How loud was it?
Oh, just very loud. Wake me up.
A number of inquiries were made into the background of the occupants of the unit, and obviously from that we'll make certain linkages in relation to motivations in relation to this crime.
Mark, in the last hour, police have said that they do believe this was a targeted shooting. We'll bring you all the latest on this investigation as it comes.
Well, millions of low and middle-income earners are set to benefit from a tax return gift of more than $1,000 as the federal government desperately tries to win votes and stay in power. Let's go straight to political reporter Ailey Walsh in Canberra. Ailey, take us through what we know so far.
Well, Mark, we know the Treasurer is bringing forward tax cuts slated for a couple of years' time and recasting them so low and middle income earners are the focus. The government, of course, has to silence Labor's attacks that everything is going up except wages. And to do that, they are doubling the $530 cashback offset. Now, that means more than 4 million Aussies will get more than $1,000 back in tax cuts. And of course, coming into an election, the government is trying to counter fears that it favours the top end of town. Now, there'll also be billions of dollars for roads and for infrastructure, particularly, Mark, in those marginal seats. There'll be a $75 cash handout to deal with rising power prices and tweaks to superannuation, allowing those close to retirement to top up their accounts. But a key sales point for Scott Morrison and for Josh Frydenberg will be a return to surplus after more than a decade. And that's been helped along, though, by those coal and iron ore prices. Of course, we know all budgets are political, but this one, I think even more so, this close to an election. Today is not just a budget, but a campaign launch. Here's the Treasurer.
Average families can expect out of this budget that their cost of living pressures will be eased.
OK, now, Scott Morrison is well aware of just how crucial this budget is for the government and for him. If this, of course, bodes badly, it will spell disaster for both the PM and the Treasurer. This will be Josh Frydenberg's first budget. Mark, it will be handed down at 7:30.
Ellie Walsh in Canberra, thank you. Harrowing video has revealed the haunting aftermath of a scaffolding collapse that killed an 18-year-old apprentice in Sydney. Live now to Jared Brevi. Jared, are the workers back on site today?
Well, Mark, as you'd expect, construction remains suspended here, but we have seen large groups of tradespeople arrive here at the site office all morning. There's been tears, they've been consoling each other and trying to come to terms with this tragedy that's unfolded right in front of them here yesterday. 18-year-old Christopher Cassaniti was killed when that nine-storey scaffolding tower collapsed on top of him. That new video we have received shows the harrowing moments following the collapse. You can see his colleagues are trying desperately to get Mr. Cassaniti out of that massive pile of metal, but they're pushed back by police who fear further collapses. Today, there's been emotional tributes for the teenager while his colleagues here have been receiving support. We spoke to the CFMEU a short time ago.
Obviously, everyone here on site's very affected by what happened here yesterday. and it's going to be a trying time moving forward. So obviously the union's priority first and foremost is to look after the health and well-being of all the workers here that obviously witnessed an absolute tragedy yesterday, and make sure that they get the help that's required to try and help them through this process.
Now, one other worker was injured yesterday, a 39-year-old man. He's now in the Royal North Shore Hospital in a stable condition. Safe Work New South Wales are trying now to get to the bottom of what has caused this shocking workplace tragedy. Mark.
Jared Brevi at Macquarie Park. Thank you. A video has been released of the moment a grandmother and a two-year-old girl were struck by a hit-and-run driver in Melbourne southeast. In a bid to track down the culprit, the pair were knocked down as they crossed Burren Road in Glen Huntly in February. The driver of the Black Toyota RAV4 pulled up briefly before returning to his car and fleeing the scene. The child suffered bruising and trauma, while a 63-year-old woman remains in hospital. Well, police searching the Queensland property of missing man Davin Thornton are examining a freezer believed to contain his remains, which was discovered during a dig in his backyard. Nine's Harry Clarker is in Goodna, southwest of Brisbane. Harry, what are police saying?
Mark, it seems police have made a very grim discovery indeed. Davin Thornton hasn't been seen for several weeks, but police's investigation into his missing persons report have led them back here to his property at Goodna in Ipswich. They spent yesterday using an excavator to dig up part of Mr. Thornton's backyard. They unearthed what appears to be a large chest freezer. Now, it's understood that that chest freezer may contain the decaying remains of Mr. Thornton, although forensic examinations are yet to confirm this. This morning, some of Mr. Thornton's relatives have come to lay flowers and friends. It's obviously a very distressing time for anyone who knows David Thornton.
He was a great man. Always good for chats, advice. Always here for you if you need it.
It's just very sad because Dave was a nice guy. Kept to himself, and I sort of didn't have much to do with him, but said hello, hi. Yeah, sad.
Now, a short time ago, forensic officers arrived back here on the scene. Police and detectives are continuing to talk to witnesses to try and determine exactly what has happened to this 58-year-old. His property here at Goodna is expected to remain a crime scene for some time yet.
Harry Clark, live from Goodna, thank you. Well, incredible new pictures have surfaced of an alleged armed crime spree across Melbourne's southeast. It comes as three suspects face court. Sam Cucciara reports.
This incredible dashcam vision has captured the moment an innocent mother was caught up in yesterday's dramatic crime spree across Melbourne's southeastern suburbs. This footage shows a dark-coloured car with three armed bandits speeding through a red light before slamming into that mother's car, which flips before taking out a traffic light. That stolen car then continues with the crooks jumping out and darting across the road while waving their weapons.
Everybody who was running towards to help those people involved in the accident, they couldn't go when they saw the gun.
Following this crash, the bandits have then carjacked another driver at gunpoint here in Carrum Downs.
Then they pointed at the gun and, pointed at the man and then ran away with the car.
Before crashing that blue ute in the nearby suburb of Cranbourne, putting an end to this trio's mad dash from the law, they were eventually crash-tackled by police and taken into custody. In all, this wild crime spree and chase lasted some 2 hours, with at least four vehicles stolen and a police car damaged. Somehow, nobody was seriously injured in all of this. A 26-year-old man, a 22-year-old man, and a 21-year-old woman have now all been charged.